What's up? So, I just got back from a crazy cross-country road trip in which I visited the world's largest casino.
Another one.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a...
So, believe it or not, the world's largest casino is in Oklahoma. It's about an hour and a half away from Dallas, Texas, on the Texas-Oklahoma border. It's called the Windstar, and I'm about to head inside. Let's go. So from what I gathered online, there's three hotel towers here, and they have about 1,500 rooms. They aren't the biggest hotel, but they have the biggest casino gaming floor. So I've spent the last hour just roaming around, and it's insane.
Goodbye for now.
So unfortunately, after only about 30 minutes, I was told I couldn't film with my camera, so I had to put that away. So the Windstar has a big giant building that's the casino, and then separate from that are two towers, two hotel towers with a ton of rooms. Now, unfortunately, they actually were only letting people who have their casino club card, club members, stay at the hotel. So I actually couldn't even get a room, which is kind of a bummer. And in addition to that, they were at 50% capacity, so they were even more limited. But I did explore the entire casino. I explored the little pool area, and I got a couple shots of the towers. I didn't go inside the hotel towers, but I got a nice shot of the outside, and I did see the lobby of the hotel, at least. I was doing some research as well. So this casino is technically in Oklahoma. It's about an hour and a half away from Dallas. It's right on the border of Texas and Oklahoma. And I found out that in Texas, it's actually illegal. They can't have casinos. There's only actually one legal casino in all of Texas, and it's like a super small, not very popular casino. It's not part of their culture at all. So I guess that kind of explains why this is in Oklahoma. Overall, the casino was massive, and I have been to a bunch of casinos, obviously. Some of the best and biggest casinos in the world are right here in Las Vegas, but I've never seen a bigger casino floor than that. Now, the theme of the casino, it's called the Windstar World Casino. So the theme of the casino is each section of the casino is like a different section of the world, and they have corresponding decor to go along with that. So my original plan for my road trip was actually not to just go to this big, awesome casino. My original plan was actually to just hit the open road, to visit some friends, to kind of take a vacation of sorts. I figured along the way I'd make a few pit stops at casinos and hotels to make some videos. But shortly after getting to the Windstar, I realized it was hard for me to kind of be in take a break mode, but also still kind of video and work mode. So I actually really didn't end up filming much of my 2-week trip. So I'll try to kind of summarize for you right here. And I'm sorry, I really wasn't posting at all on social media. So for about 2 weeks, if you're wondering where the heck I was and what I was doing, this is what I was doing. I'll tell you right now. So I left Vegas. I went all the way to Oklahoma. I stayed in a hotel right next to the Windstar. And then I spent the day exploring the Windstar. And then after that, I made my way all the way up to Pennsylvania to visit my friend Perry and some of my best college buddies. So that was really fun. It was really nice to see them. It had been so long since I've seen them because the pandemic kind of just messed up everything. So it was awesome to catch up. We kind of just hung out, played video games, and ate.
So I've literally been at Perry's for 6 days. I didn't film anything, but I wanted to film something before I left. So this is Perry. This is Perry's dog, Mia. Hi, Mia.
Good girl.
I'm about to head out. Gotta start the road trip. It was nice to see you, bro.
Great to see you, man. I'll miss you.
But after that, spent a few days there, I turned around and I went back south and towards Vegas. But on my way, I once again stopped in Texas and I visited my friend Mike, who lives in Austin, Texas. And Austin was a good time. Austin's one of those really popular cities right now, so it was really cool to see that. I actually went to my first Whole Foods of all time, so, you know, bucket list, check that off. But yeah, it was really nice to see a bunch of my friends. And it was also really cool to just be on the road, be off the internet, you know, be listening to music or audiobooks, and oftentimes just, you know, listening to my thoughts, you know, just kind of thinking about different things. I had really put a lot of time and effort and thought into a film I'm working on writing. So I had really a lot of time just driving and thinking about these scenes and things like that. So that was really good for me. And now I'm back in Vegas. I'm so happy. I'm so refreshed. I have a lot in store as well. All great news. I did make one more stop before getting back to Vegas though. I stopped in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And according to Google, I stayed at the top rated hotel and casino. It's called the Sandia Resort and Casino, and it's in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and that was really great. I got a lot of footage of that as well, so I'll show you that right now. Good morning from Albuquerque, New Mexico. All right, I need coffee. I'm gonna show you the room now. So the room cost me $239. Also, I wanted to mention that the whole casino has a Native American theme. So throughout the casino, you'll see statues of Native American figures and images, and even the carpet has Native American, like a style, Native American style to it. It's really neat, especially the one in the hallways. Really cool. Pretty cool casino. All right, next stop before I officially hit the road is where they filmed the famous chicken spot in Breaking Bad, Los Pollos Hermanos. It's actually called Twisters. Time to hit the road. Bye, Twisters. So that's it for this one. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you're caught up a little bit. Thank you to the ones who messaged me and reached out and were worried about me. I really am sorry if you were worrying about me. Everything was great. I just was avoiding the internet pretty much. So next time I'll do a little bit better job at explaining that before I leave and ghosting everyone. So sorry about that. But anyway, back to normal scheduled programming.